It's time for Rethinking Retirement with Marvin Mitchell, Senior Financial Advisor and President of Compass Retirement Solutions. Today we are talking about Social Security and how to know when is the right time to start taking your Social Security funds. Marvin, what advice do you start with regarding Social Security?
The first piece of advice is not to follow cookie cutter advice. And what I mean by that, there are people out there who would tell you that you should always wait to take Social Security. I don't agree. There are also people who say you should always take it as soon as you can. Again, I don't agree. And if you try to call the Social Security Administration, you have to understand that their job is not to give you advice. They can't inform you on how to take it. They can just basically answer questions. And sometimes if you call, you get two different answers from two different people, but that's a whole nother story. So when do you actually wait? So there are times that you should actually wait to take Social Security. One of those things is pretty evident. If you're still working, even when you turn 62 and you're still working, you definitely have to understand that if you make over a certain amount, over about $18,000, you'll be penalized by about 50% for every dollar that you make while you're working at 62. Now, once you're full retirement age, which for some of you is 66 and some of you are 67, then you can actually still work and make as much money as you want. That's one situation where you might decide to wait. Another situation is if you are the higher income earner and you're married, you have to understand that when one of you pass away, you only get to keep one of those Social Security checks, so sometimes it makes sense to wait. A lot of people want to know what's the break-even age. The break-even age is typically around somewhere about 82, 83 years old if you take it at 62 versus full retirement age. But there are also times, Molly, where you should take it early. I'll give you an example. Let's just say I'm 64 and I'm retired and I need about an additional $20,000 out of my portfolio, but the portfolio is only worth $300,000. Well, that is putting way too much pressure on your portfolio at an early stage, and if a bad market happens, you may not even make it to full retirement age and still have money left in your account. So in that situation, it might make sense to take it early. So it's very important that you have a plan. You absolutely need a plan because it's not as simple as take it this age or take it that age. Sometimes it makes sense to take it at different times. If you're a married couple, one person might take it early and one person might wait. And those are a lot of the questions that people have, Molly.
And Marvin, you wrote a book called Retire Early. You do offer that for free. How can people get your book?
Absolutely. So this book, you can get it by going to rethinkingretirement.net. Now, when you get this book, understand that one of the questions is, when should we take Social Security? So we're actually going to answer that question within this book, so you don't want to miss it. Rethinkingretirement.net, and we got all of the information that you need to at least get on the right path to making a great decision.
All right, Marvin, thank you so much. Once again, you can check out that free book by going to rethinkingretirement.net. I'm Molly Rose.